Thank you. Called Fields, and the next one I'm going to do, I think, is kind of the one where I actually geek out more than the other times, and it's called Stemming, and it's which is tuning fork in Dutch, tuning actually, and it's kind of based on the idea that you know, this this is like a resonating surface, and there are these vibrations that are interactions with the oxygen in the air, et cetera, and how fast things vibrate and how we perceive them. And so I kind of take the idea of tuning is a big deal, you know, because each of these bridges has to be tuned individually. We have to tune. I think a gentleman in the audience was talking about how when he was in the army, they tuned the propellers. If I correct me if I get this wrong, but they adjusted one propeller of the airplane so that it was the correct speed, and then they tuned the other propeller to be at the same speed. Is that true? Am I saying it right? Okay, good. Thank you. So I thought that was fascinating because, this kind of activity takes place pretty much in all facets of our lives. So, I work with this idea of the tuning fork and also the beating that takes place when there's a differences. And so I bring it into the computer and kind of work with the oscillators. And I think when people experience like a piano that's out of tune or the kind of beatings that take place, and certainly in the installation, there's different times when the beatings occur, and working also with different intonations of tuning other than just intonation. Other than equal temperament, there's different kinds of beatings that occur too. So it's really a fascinating psychoacoustic. And also I think kind of, deeply, there's something very, very primal and basic about how we hear vibrations in the air and et cetera. So that's a little too long-winded, I'm sorry. I'm gonna do one more piece, but the whole time I was playing that, I was really thinking about those propellers. So I was wondering, I could just acknowledge, do you mind coming up? I want you to tell that story because it's such an amazing story. And I'm sorry, I forgot your name, sir.
I'm very free, but.
Okay, you don't.
It's very simple. With twin-engine propeller airplanes, the common thing was to run one engine up and then adjust it to the desired speed. And you listen to this, the buzz of the engine actually was increased to almost a hum. Then they would bring the speed of the second engine up and it would create this same kind of beat sound until they gradually increased them to the same speed and they synchronized them and it made one single sound. The same thing that she has achieved in getting everything to come together in the circle at the F sharp.
Thank you. Glad that you would spend the evening with us to experience the work of Miya Masaoka. Her performance tonight is entitled A Line Becomes a Circle. As I said in the pre-concert talk, she is an artist of with many different influences, many different aspects. On the one hand, she is a master performer of the koto, a traditional Japanese instrument. She is a sound artist, which is suggested at least by the array of equipment that is up here attached to her koto. And her work is, in many respects, entirely modern, but yet it's in conversation with traditional Japanese culture. So please welcome Miya Masaoka.